Herobrine is the most famous myth and legend in all of gaming, becoming so synonymous with Minecraft itself that even after Notch would repeatedly tell players he didn't exist, players would still report seeing him in their worlds. From 2010 to 2014, Herobrine not only spread through the internet like wildfire, but also seemingly made thousands of appearances in players' survival worlds, forever cementing himself as a nostalgic legend of Minecraft's earliest days. However, nobody knows who created Herobrine exactly. Nobody knows how Herobrine came to be. And almost nobody knows that for 13 years now, the story of Herobrine has been very wrong. Herobrine's true origin story and original form were only just recently discovered. We all know the legend of Herobrine, but I'll give you a brief rundown of his most known origin story as a refresher. Herobrine was first mentioned in an old creepypasta on 4chan, where a player recounts his paranormal experiences and posts the first ever screenshot of Herobrine. The player recently spawned in a new single-player world, where everything was normal at first as he began chopping down some trees. Amongst the fog, he saw what he thought was a cow, but it was another character, with empty eyes and no name. He tried to pursue the strange figure out of curiosity, but before he knew it, he was gone. The player then began finding strange things around his world, 2x2 tunnels, sand pyramids, trees with no leaves. The player took to the forums to ask if anybody else had seen such an anomaly, to which his post was deleted by a user named Herobrine, who told him to stop. The player then managed to get in contact with other users on the forums who had claimed to see him, and after further research, it was supposedly revealed that Herobrine was the name of Notch's dead brother. From there, a player called Copeland stumbled across the creepypasta and liked it. Copeland was part of a streaming duo with his friend called Brocraft and decided to Photoshop Herobrine into a screenshot of his world, getting great reactions out of his chat. So, he decided to do a stream where he would encounter Herobrine, of which we now know was a retextured painting. His viewers and the community did not though, and soon after his encounter, Copeland would post the clip to the Minecraft forums, where it would receive almost 700 responses. Most players at the time were freaked out, scared to touch the game again, and utterly terrified by the clip. From there, Herobrine and this clip spread all around the Minecraft community, with a variety of other players having their own sightings and telling their own stories of strange occurrences in their worlds. By this point, Notch and Mojang had become well aware of Herobrine and, as a joke, decided to include, starting in beta 1.6.6, the famous removed Herobrine text in the game's changelogs. This would be a regular occurrence, appearing in a variety of Minecraft updates at the time, and this tradition is still continued today, with it last being mentioned in the 1.20 changelogs. Back then, the changelogs used to immediately appear when you opened the Minecraft launcher, and as such, a lot of people saw Herobrine was removed and likely googled him out of confusion to get more information, growing his popularity immensely. And the rest is history. There have been mods, hundreds of sighting videos with millions of views, and a lot of videos revisiting the now well-known story of Herobrine. And they are all wrong. Now, something many of you may not have noticed is that back in 2010, Herobrine was regularly referred to as another name, him. In fact, Copeland's original sighting thread, where Herobrine first began gaining popularity, referred to Herobrine as just him as well. You can find a lot of posts referencing him and his mythical white eyes, Herobrine's key feature, and the sole thing distinguishing him from Steve. But things start to get confusing when you realize that many of these posts where Herobrine is not named at all, but instead referred to as just him, were made days or even weeks before Copeland's sighting, and seem to refer to a different entity altogether. Let's first go back to July the 31st, 2010, exactly 1 month before Copeland's stream. A post was made to the forums called 13.ogg, a work of fiction, by user I'm a Hedgehog. Just a day before this post, Minecraft Alpha 1.0.14, a secret Friday update, had released containing Disc 13, which at the time, alongside Cat, were the first two music discs to ever be added to Minecraft. Cat was a nice melodic disc, pleasant to listen to, but on the other hand, 13 was extremely unsettling, off-putting, and outright creepy. It's important to note that Minecraft at the time during Alpha was significantly scarier. The darker lighting, lack of a brightness slider, secret updates where Notch would add features to the game without telling players what exactly was added, amongst the game's young age leading to players not knowing much about it, made Minecraft a vast, scary, and unknown world at the time. Not only that, but cave ambience noises were also only recent additions to the game at the time, making Minecraft much scarier, especially when in pitch black caves. Players were very confused about 13's addition upon discovering the disc in-game, creating stories about it and theorizing if there was more to the disc than what they could see, or rather hear. I'm a Hedgehog happened to write one of those posts, a fictional tale of the lore behind Disc 13. But what's actually notable about this thread isn't the original post, rather a comment on the third page left a few hours later by a user called Flaky. Flaky had reposted a story from an anonymous user on 4chan that went like this. I think I'm going crazy. I abandoned my mind due to strange shit happening, like blocks coming out of nowhere and my torches going missing. It was really strange. The strange thing was that there wasn't a single monster or slime or anything down there, but there was a lot of minerals. Quite a lot of cave ambience that I've never heard before. Must have been included in the Secret Friday update, I dunno. But recently I've been hearing really strange things around the building I boot around it. It feels like whispers. It's strange really. I feel like going back down there, but I really don't want to because of the creepy shit that happens, plus I'd need a lot more torches. It just seems that the cave is alive and angry at me. I decided to go down there one day, one last time to see if I could get any stuff that I could, before truly abandoning it. I couldn't find a single one of my torches that I left down there. I don't know what's happening to them. This just made me want to leave the cave even more. I spent about 2 minutes inside and noticed that I couldn't hear anything. The ambience stopped. At this point, I was creeped out and decided to leave before it got dark outside. I left the cave and turned around, and the hole went dark, as if once again, my torches were removed. I ran without looking back. The anonymous player continues on, mentioning he flooded the cave with lava buckets and then let it be for a few days. He began to run low on cobblestone and iron, but did not want to ever set foot in that cursed cave again, instead making a new base further away from his current one. He did so and went back to mining again, until he accidentally fell into a very dark cave. The player continued exploring, eventually coming across his very first dungeon. However, strangely, no mobs were spawning. He checked the chest, the first was completely empty, the second contained an unusual item he had never seen before, a black disc. He decided to leave the cave to check out this strange item more, and as he was doing so, he began to find holes in the walls that weren't there before. He continued towards his exit, but his torches were suddenly gone again. Then, out of the blue, loud cave ambience played, and the player, terrified, began running and placing as many torches as possible. The player makes it back to his base, and now wanting to play the disc, had to go back to his old base to get diamonds to make a jukebox. As he reluctantly arrived at his old house, all the torches were gone. He went to his mining room to get the diamonds from his chest, and couldn't help but take a quick peek at his old mine. He slowly poked his head down. It was dark, and nothing could be seen, except for two white dots next to each other, like eyes. Something was down there, looking into my eyes. I felt like I was looking at death itself. I felt dizzy and fell backwards into a solid object, the door, which was open just seconds ago. I bashed my way through it and through the other door outside. It was still night, but I didn't care. I ran back to my shack with my heart pounding in my chest like it wanted to escape. I got in and closed my door, destroyed my windows, the door, everything that could let me see the outside world, and placed as many torches as possible. I didn't want to see darkness again. I went into a corner and sat there terrified. Why me? Why didn't this happen to anyone else? The player put the disc inside the jukebox, mentioning that he was lost at what he had just listened to, claiming it was evil and needed to be destroyed. The player decided he had to return to the cursed cave to throw the disc in the lava he flooded it with days before. As he enters the cave, he hears a ghoulish laugh behind him, and in the pitch black, two white eyes were looking right at him. He turns and runs, finding a dark pit, and looking straight back at him from the pit are the white eyes getting bigger and bigger. He begins hearing voices and whispers as well as music in his head, but continues on to the lava pit. He can't go any further though, the disc won't let him. It has consumed him. He is unable to destroy the disc, and possessed, he returns to his home, back where the disc belongs. The post has this video linked in it, a video with only 54,000 views, uploaded on July the 31st, 2010. The video is simply an image of a dark Minecraft cave with the 13 disc playing. However, there are a pair of small white eyes in the corner, amongst the darkness. In the comments, some players even mentioned if this is the mysterious white eyes they kept hearing about. White eyes? Who is White Eyes? Well, I'm not entirely sure, but what I can say is that all of this White Eyes stuff is really scaring me. Scaring me just as much as the number of viewers who are not subscribed. You all better change that, or else. No pressure, of course. Anyways, one day later on the 1st of August, another post would be made to the Minecraft forums by user Endorphine titled, "I cannot take it anymore," which gives us some more information surrounding this White Eyes creature. Jesus Christ, I can't do it. I can't take it anymore. I can't go back home. I can't go into my mines. I can't do anything anymore but slowly try and build something under the frozen ocean. And it's all because of two little pixels. Two pixels. Two white pixels. I haven't even seen them myself, except in screenshots. I know it's there though, waiting in the mines, watching me from my tower's balcony while I'm outside. I can't see it through the constant snowfall, but I know it's there, and I know it can see me. The White Eyes myth surrounding ambient noises. It started a couple weeks after a secret Friday update. Some people started reporting seeing a pair of white pixels whenever an underground ambient noise was triggered. I figured it was just a bug or something, maybe some way he did it to trigger the sounds themselves. I didn't hear much more about it for a while. Then all of a sudden recently, I've been seeing reported sightings everywhere and a supposed screenshot of them. This post once again linked to the same YouTube video with the same image. In the comments of the post, there are some skeptics, but also many people reporting having the exact same experience. These two stories are the first of the known White Eyes sightings, but seem to indicate that there were many more sightings prior. And this is further backed up by users complaining of these posts, mentioning they had gotten sick of seeing so many people talk about white eyes. There are a handful of posts from early August 2010, where players mentioned spotting white eyes in the pitch black darkness of caves, providing links that are now unfortunately dead, as well as recounts of their sightings. Flaky would even create fan art of white eyes and what players at the time believed it to look like, but once again, all links are dead with no archives, likely lost to time. Amongst the many curious and terrified players, some players in the original thread by Endorphine mentioned it was a rendering bug or graphical glitch where a block's texture does not fully fit to the block's edges. There are in fact similar bug reports from a few years later of such rendering bugs, but Endorphine declined such an idea, and notably mentioned right here in response to one such player that they were wrong and it was White Eyes as we named her. Her? Okay, we need to pause here. Who is White Eyes? What does White Eyes actually look like? What does Herobrine have to do with all this? And where did the White Eyes story come from? And to understand that, we need to skip ahead a few years, 13 to be exact. You see, in May of this year, small YouTuber Aussie Flawol came across the I Cannot Take It Anymore thread, and in doing so began noticing some inconsistencies with the Herobrine story. First of all, Aussie Flawol discovered that the link of the supposed original Herobrine image and copypasta contained what's known as a Unix timestamp, a special computer time format used to basically stamp a date on when certain things on a computer were done. Anywho, this timestamp, when converted using a website, gave the date August 31st, 2010. But what's odd is that the version of the game which is in the screenshot is a version released August 13th, which then became outdated 1 week later on August 20th. So this screenshot had to be taken within this 7-day period. Furthermore, the earliest known mention of Herobrine was on Twitter, where a now deleted user tagged Notch, telling him to add Herobrine to Minecraft on August 19th. So, how is it that Herobrine could have originated from a post made almost 2 weeks later? Well, as it turns out, the original creepypasta image posted to 4chan, long believed to be the original source and creation of Herobrine, was in fact not the original, and that same image can actually also be found in Copeland's original thread, posted by a user called The Camera Works, one day earlier than the one on 4chan. So, the original source of the image, and thus creepypasta, which was made sometime during August the 13th to August the 19th, 2010, likely before the 19th due to that tweet, is now unknown. And keep in mind, at earliest, this all occurred 2 to 3 weeks after the creation of White Eyes. Is White Eyes just a different form of Herobrine? Well, let's quickly get a timeline of events because it all happened so fast. On the 31st of July, that video with the White Eyes image and Disc 13 audio was uploaded to YouTube. That same day, Flaky would repost the White Eyes story. Then, a day later on August the 1st, the I Can't Take It Anymore thread, where White Eyes was officially named, was posted, as well as the now lost fan art of what White Eyes was supposed to look like. While those images are gone, Ozzy was able to conceptualize White Eyes' form based on comments responding to the fan art, which described it as a skeleton spider hybrid. The model you've seen in this video is one I got custom made based on those conceptualizations, by the way. A few dozen White Eyes posts later, and then on August the 24th, a user on the forums named Goaty made a post about their own White Eyes encounter, where they supposedly ran into a player on their single player world with whited out eyes and the default Steve skin. This is the first known conceptualization of the Herobrine we are all familiar with today, and also where he began being referred to as a man, particularly him. There were no mentions of the name Herobrine yet, this was still just White Eyes. Interestingly, a comment on that post mentioned that this is the second story they've now seen of a white-eyed player model, potentially implying that the original post and story are yet to be found, and maybe the first ever post or thread where Herobrine was created. Considering that tweet was made 5 days before this thread, it's highly likely. Anywho, continuing on, and Copeland did his stream encountering him, and the rest is history. Let's now go back to that original video where the White Eyes image was first made by Kerchak Kerchak. Was this the original creator of White Eyes, and thus the inspiration, or even the creator of Herobrine? Ozzy Flawol and a few others managed to get in contact with them on Discord, who mentioned that they didn't remember exactly why they put the white dots in the bottom of the image, but confirmed it might have been inspired by the same rendering bug we mentioned earlier, and was more of just a fun joke. They didn't write the original 4chan creepypasta Flaky reposted, nor created the concept of White Eyes. It's still a mystery. So, what's believed to have happened is this. Someone on 4chan saw this video, likely when looking for Disc 13's audio, and came up with the White Eyes story based on the image and the creepy Disc 13 audio. That story was then reposted to the forums by Flaky, and then Endorphin created their similar post, potentially inspired by the story Flaky reposted, and officially named her White Eyes. From there, somewhere between August the 13th and August the 19th, Herobrine was created. And somewhere between August the 13th and August the 25th, his Steve form and identity was conceptualized, likely as some player's interpretation of the original White Eyes story. Herobrine evolved from White Eyes, or was heavily inspired by her. He was not the first and not the original, but a mere different version of the White Eyes myth that was so commonly known at the time. This creepypasta and image is likely not the first Herobrine story or encounter. Flaky's reposted story is the first known instance whereby White Eyes, and thus later Herobrine, was created. Yet, it was Herobrine who became cemented in Minecraft history, with White Eyes forgotten to time. The problem is, this just leaves us with more questions than answers. The original creator and source of White Eyes is unknown. The original creator and source of Herobrine is also now even more of a mystery than before. While it was previously believed that the original source of Herobrine was this creepypasta, we now know there's a good chance it was created elsewhere. Where did the name Herobrine even come from? How did we go from White Eyes to Herobrine? These are questions we may never answer. All the notable individuals involved have attempted to be tracked down and contacted by Ozzy and others, part of the White Eyes research team on Discord, with only Cura responding thus far. This is where we need your help. If you happen to know or are any of the individuals mentioned in this video, please join the White Eyes Discord below or leave a comment on this video, as you could hold the keys to finding the truth behind White Eyes and Herobrine. Share this video around so as many people as possible can see it as well. So what have we learned from this entire ordeal? Well, what's so cool about Herobrine is that now, over 13 years later, new information is still being uncovered, with potentially more still left to find, continuing to cement how legendary she truly was. I hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to subscribe. Thank you all so much for watching.